All right, I'm recording this to show the process of creating a pick list from a customer order. And I have here Smart Office already open. And I'm running OS 300 here. Okay, it's showing me a lot of customer orders, but I only want those that are status 33 for the minimum. Or the lowest. So I'm gonna filter this and just select 33 for the allocated, and then for the highest I'm gonna select 44, picking list, and I'm gonna click apply. Right now I have two and I would wanna select I will try to create more lines. Let's see if I have how many lines I have in this customer order right here. I'm gonna check that by doing a related options and option 15, which is order lines. It seems that I only have one, so I'm gonna add some more lines in this customer order. And I'm gonna use this same item, probably just change the last number, and there it is. And say I'll need two of these, and I'll click add, and then I'll insert another one, maybe the next item, which is ending in two, and I'll put five in that, click add. And probably do this again for using the same items. At least I'll create at least four more lines. And I'll put six in here. Okay, and I click add. That's a warning, that's okay. I can just click OK for the sake of demo because I'm using the same item. In reality, you wouldn't want to be doing this, but that's okay as long as I have more lines. And then I'll put four and click OK. So now I'm expecting, I have added four more lines to the existing one, and it's shown here by their status. And now I can click close. I'll get out of the customer order lines. So right here in OIS 300, back to OIS 300, I'm gonna check all those lines that I've added by going to the delivery toolbox. And I want to take a look at my second delivery number, which is 110, because there's already an existing delivery number earlier. And I want to release them for picking, which I will do by selecting the related options 32. All right, it takes a while for this to be updated, and that's going to be indicated if I already have a one right under the RP, which is release for picking. So I'm gonna hit the refresh button. Sometimes takes a lot longer depending on the number of lines. I can also do that by going back to from the delivery toolbox or MWS 410. I can go back to YS 300, and previously it's at status 33. It should now turn into status 44 after the release has been completed. Okay, I'm trying to click refresh again. It looks like it already have some that are already at status 44. At We check back with the delivery toolbox, related options. Already have one under the RP or release per pick. And I will check if all the lines are already released. I can do that by checking the delivery lines. I'm going to do that from the related options. And all four of the items that I've added already here. And it looks that they are all released now. So what I'm going to do, as soon as I've added all the lines and I've released them for picking, we can now check the picking list, which was created after that release for picking process. And this is how to do it. From the related options, or rather from MWS 410, go to related options in option 11, picking list. It's going to show me the pick list that was created. And to check the details, I'm going to select this picking list and do another related option. And I will select the picking line. So I'm going to have to do it from here to show the details right there. And these are all the picking lines that I have from that pick list. And if you notice, these are the same items that I've inserted in the customer order earlier. So there's two of this item one and there's two of the item two. And these are all the quantities that they have. All right. So that's that. All the picker need to do now is just scan and pick those lines. Scan the item and pick those lines. All right. I'm going to try to do that now. I'm going to go back to my pick list. And I'm gonna open the lines again. I will do it from the related options again. Picking these lines. At this point, I'm assuming that I'm actually picking the item. So I will be the picker looking at my pick list right here. And my pick list is showing four lines or four items to be picked. And each time I scan the item or tap my Google Glass for this matter, what the system's gonna do is confirm the issuance of this record. So for first line, I have two quantities of item Y10001. What the picker's gonna do is pick two of those items. And after picking the last item, he's gonna tap his device, in this case the Google Glass, and then what the system is gonna do is confirm the issuance, and it's gonna disappear from the picking list, and the picker is gonna be doing the same thing for all the other lines, and each time he completes his picking, the number of quantities have been picked or taken out from inventory. He's going to tap his glass, and this is what the system will do each time he does that. So he'll keep doing that until he completes all the picking. And in our case, this will be the last since we only have four lines. Once that's done, we no longer have picking lines, so the pick list has been completed. As you can see, it changed to status 90 in the system, so we go back to our order. Delivery is also at status 90 right here, and going back to our order, it's already at status 66. The lowest is at status 33 because that's the first record that's been there when we opened the customer order. All right, that's it. So this is how you create a picking list and complete the picking process.